as the water moves in all around them. Annalisa.
Kim, Blake and Danielle Thompson say first it was hail, then a tornado warning, and now they've been experiencing flooding since yesterday. They say they don't live in a flood zone and have never seen anything like this.
There's no words to describe your reaction. It's fear and panic.
Yeah, I started packing up most important papers and just some things we could put in some backpacks in case we had to get out of here.
This is what the couple's backyard normally looks like, and this is what it looked like around 9:30 last night. The couple says water reached around the top of this white line at their house. They say the foundation is damaged, stairs have washed away, and carpets inside the house are wet.
Lots of prayers. Lots of prayers. We're still in panic mode and gonna call the insurance as soon as we can to see what we can. But we're not in a flood zone, so I don't know if we have flood insurance. You know, that it's all unknown. It's all unknown territory for us.
Another Dexter resident sent this video, and you can see water rushing all around the homes. Viewers also sent photos of hail the area saw yesterday. The Dexter fire chief says they've been responding to calls of down power lines, stalled vehicles, and they've helped evacuate people from their cars and homes. Thankfully, they say so far there have been no injuries related to the weather that they know of. And about 20 miles north, Roswell has seen more than 4 inches of rain in the last 24 hours. A group called Roswell Community Disaster Relief Services is helping people affected by the flooding. They are spending the day recovering cars stuck and water and are asking for volunteers to help fill sandbags and donate money and supplies. Back to you.
Okay, thanks, Annalisa. Now 5:30, we'll hear from a business owner who was forced to close her doors because of the damage from the weather.